researchers have developed a new type of transistor, the building block of all modern electronics. This new device is almost 1,000 times more energy efficient than classical transistor and emits almost zero heat. Personally, I'm very excited about this innovation because this new technology could solve some of the biggest challenges of the computing industry today. Let's break it down. Heat is a major problem for all modern computer chips, whether it's your laptop or a high-performance GPU cluster or a quantum computer. Heat is a problem since it limits the performance and efficiency. And efficiency is everything. The most powerful supercomputer, Frontier, achieved the milestone of 1 exaflop at the cost of roughly 21 megawatts of power. If we look ahead in front of us to the next milestone, zeta scale, and assuming that efficiency will roughly double every 2 years, here we would need 500 megawatts of power to achieve zeta scale performance. Now, just to give you a feeling, 1 gigawatt of power is actually a nuclear power plant. So every data center would require a dedicated nuclear power plant. It's obvious that we need to find a better way here. Quantum computers face even greater challenge, as they cannot tolerate heat at all. Heat destroys the delicate state of quantum entanglement. This is why we build these big, intricate systems around them, to keep the quantum circuits cool. So these are big, complex problems with no easy solution. And that's where these new devices from IBM and Semicon come in. Semicon, a Finnish company, has developed the world's first transistor that operates at nearly zero heat dissipation. It consumes just 0.1% of the power of traditional transistors and reduces heat dissipation by 1,000 times. This technology has implications for more powerful data centers, high-performance computing, even space-grade electronics, and of course, in quantum computing field. And what's so interesting here, typically when we talk about orders of magnitude improvement in transistor technology, it often involves exotic architecture or exotic materials, which is actually not the case here. These new devices are based on so-called SOI, CMOS technology, silicon on insulator technology, which is already widely adopted and used in industries like automotive and wireless. This means these new transistors can be mass produced using existing CMOS fabrication plants, requiring no new infrastructure. Essentially, these new devices are quite similar to classical transistors, with one key difference. They are built using an ultra-thin layer of silicon on top of an insulator, whereas traditional transistors constructed on bulk silicon. What is so interesting? Classical transistors cannot work at low temperatures, and the biggest problem is that their performance changes as temperature decreases. To be specific, as temperature goes down, we need to apply higher voltage to switch transistor on. That's why, as temperature changes, transistors cannot function consistently. And this is a big problem in high-performance computing applications as well as in quantum devices, because in both of these cases, having precise control is critical. In their new paper, Semicon team describes how they solved this problem with a new cryogenic device design. New transistors can function at extremely low temperatures. It keeps it cool, no matter the stress. Before we dive into some exciting research from IBM and its impact on the future of computing, I want to discuss the technology that's already advancing how we work today. AMD Ryzen PRO processors are already redefining what's possible in the modern workplace. From small businesses to enterprise workflows, these processors are designed to make your workday smoother. At the core of the AMD Ryzen PRO processors is the cutting-edge architecture that integrates the CPU, GPU, and a dedicated NPU on a single chip, enabling AI-powered applications performance up to 1.8 times faster directly on your PC without relying on external hardware. Whether you're brainstorming with your team, or using AI-powered applications, editing videos, or finalizing your presentation, AMD Ryzen PRO chips deliver an experience that feels effortless. And this performance is paired with advanced security features and extreme efficiency. To put this into perspective, AI PCs powered by the Ryzen PRO series deliver up to 29 hours of battery life, giving you the freedom to work from anywhere all day long. Now to the best part. AMD is making it easy right now for businesses to see the impact firsthand with their free loaner program. Just click on the link below to test Ryzen's Pro laptops for yourself and experience all the benefits they can bring to your business. Now, why does this technology matter and which impact could it have? First of all, as these devices dissipate almost no heat, it means it can dramatically reduce the cooling efforts and the cooling costs. Data centers worldwide currently spend tens of billions of dollars annually on cooling, and this figure continues to rise year to year. This technology could potentially offer a more sustainable path forward and eliminate the need for nuclear power plants. Let me know your thoughts in the comments. Looking forward to reading it. That's actually one of the reasons why IBM has been actively working on cryogenic devices, including memory and transistors. And what they found is that these devices at lower temperature exhibit better features, like better performance, lower power consumption, and improved reliability. Recently, IBM demonstrated a new transistor built for cryogenic applications. They've shown that this new device, operating at 77 Kelvin, doubled device performance compared to its performance at room temperature. This new transistor is built with nanosheet architecture, which we've touched upon many times on this channel. Here, the channel is split into a stack of thin silicon sheets, which are completely surrounded by the gate. And to make it cryogenic, IBM has integrated dual metal gates and dipoles. Nanosheet technology is the next step in scaling down logical devices. Now, when combined with liquid nitrogen cooling, IBM managed to actually double the performance. If you are enjoying this video as much as I do, make sure to subscribe to the channel and turn on notifications not to miss the most exciting advancements in the world of technology. Thank you. Of course, this device is also a big milestone in the development of quantum computers. These typically operate at very cold temperatures, close to absolute zero. In quantum computers, it's actually very hard to prevent heat from coming in because there is always control electronics, which we use as an interface between the classical and quantum worlds for the communication and for the control of qubits. Heat introduced by control wires and external electronics can disrupt the delicate state of qubits and throw their calculations off. Just think about it. As quantum systems grow larger and larger, we integrate more qubits, means more control wires. So it's getting more challenging to preserve these cryogenic temperatures inside. These new cryogenic transistors addressing this challenge, because if we build control electronics from these cryogenic transistors, we can place it directly inside the cryostat, which will make it easier to build and much easier to scale to larger number of qubits. Beyond data centers and quantum computers, these devices will thrive in outer space, because they will be able to operate reliably at very low cold temperatures and without any additional heating or cooling systems required. As exciting as these developments are, they are of course not without a challenge. First of all, it would take quite some time to bring them from lab to mass production. And then of course there is a question of costs, because even though these devices are well scalable, still there are costs involved to build the cryogenic environment for them in case if it goes to data centers. And then there is adoption. Will tech giants be willing to invest in cryogenic systems when other energy-saving options exist? Or maybe they will go on with building nuclear power plants. This is a complicated trade-off. Let me know your thoughts in the comments. Despite these challenges, this is an important milestone and a glimpse in the future of computing, where heat is no more a bottleneck for scaling the systems up. And if this technology lives to its promise, it can transform everything from quantum computers to data centers. If you enjoyed this breakdown, make sure to give it a like and share it with your friends, colleagues, and on social media. I always see your reposts, and this makes me very happy. And I will see you one more time before the new year, very soon in the new video.